Hello and welcome to the weekly Wednesday Lunchtime Livestream. I am DDO Community Manager Cordovan. Thank you very much for joining us here on twitch.tv/DDOstream. Don't forget to give us a follow if you would like to be notified for when we're going live with shows just like this one, normally at noon Eastern, -4 GMT currently on twitch.tv/DDOstream. Running late this week due to some real-life appointments and stuff, but hey. That's what it goes. You also may notice I'm not wearing glasses. I've got contacts on today. My glasses broke over the weekend. So, all right, let's get to chat. We are on Arganesson. I've got a level 18. This is actually the Spring Fling character here that I'm going to run with today. Not quite sure what we're going to run yet. I guess we'll have to figure that out. But let me get to a couple of questions in chat. First off, someone mentioned something that I should probably start the show off with, which is Crystal Cove is back. It'll kick off tomorrow. That'll be July 2nd, late morning Eastern time, and it'll run through the 12th of July. So this weekend and next weekend, getting shut off on the morning of the 13th, Crystal Cove is back, and we know some of you guys have been asking quite a bit for it, so we're glad to bring it back to you. Good way to kind of spend some time on this U.S. July 4th holiday weekend, if that's you. Have we had any trade interface improvements, Erlock asks. Yes. My understanding is that trade tech does work with Crystal Cove, so map piece turn-ins and such will be a lot easier this time around. We do not have new items. You know, the Crystal Cove event itself is unchanged, but that interface did get brought in and updated with the update that we did earlier this year, late last year, whatever that was. So you can just say, I want to trade in 1,000 of them. Boom. Should be quite nice. Quite nice. And there was much rejoicing. Yes, indeed. All right, let's figure out what we're going to run here, huh? Where have I left off with the Spring Fling? It looks like quite a bit, actually, I have an option for. So why don't we do I don't know, what do you guys think? How about how about in the Demon's Den? It's one that we haven't featured in the stream in quite some time, or if ever, even. So that sounds pretty good. Yeah, that training stuff is nice. It's something, you know, clearly that we're quite pleased to be able to do as well. Make things a lot easier. Now, for those of you who don't know, Crystal Cove is a pirate-themed event. You can find the entrance to it in the harbor. I'll probably be pretty close to it, but so I can show you the NPC in just a smidge. But it's got a sort of a wilderness area event, and then unlocks a kobold mining challenge, which is also pretty cool. And you can get that for ingredients and make some nice items there. We do have a guide to the event on DDO.com. So if that's you, we'll need to find out more about it, and just find it on DDO.com. Look for the guides section in the tab. Yeah, I'm going to do a tough one today. I don't know why. I guess because I'm feeling like punishing myself. It'll be fun, though. Actually, this was part of McCarty Dio's 10-week challenge, and I hadn't run it back at the time, so I thought maybe now might be a fun time to do so. Demons? Where? Man, this one is so hard on Elite, but we'll see what happens. We may totally die here, but we'll see. Level 20 on Elite. Oh, we're so gonna die. Why do I do this to myself? Why do I put myself in situations where I know I'm going to fail on the live stream? Because I love you, that's why. Yep. Let's see. Wasn't it the highest free-to-play quest in the game? That might be. That's possible, actually. At one point, it was probably the case that was... might have been, right? Because I wasn't part of the Inspired Quarter Pack. So. It's an interesting note, Bacardi. I think you might be right. Yeah, because I'm having fun, right, Erlock? I mean, I know, some people have occasionally made some snarky comments in YouTube and such about how, oh, you just keep dying, man, you suck. Well, okay, one, yes, I do. But two, this whole purpose of this live stream is to have fun and to challenge myself and to just sort of get wacky. And nobody's watching this stream to have me succeed all the time, right? If I'm going for XP and stuff at home, trust me, I'm not running in the Demon's Den on Elite. But for the purpose of the live stream here, it's actually a lot of fun to do this sort of thing. So that's why I do it. I'm proud of it that I suck. Well, I'm not proud that I suck at the game. I don't think I totally suck, but on a scale of 1 to 10, probably a solid 6 or 7. But on the other hand, I'm better at this than I am at, say, like, any first-person shooter. You really want to see someone noob it up. Watch me in, like, Call of Duty. Yeah. Alright, so, occasionally I'm in the 8 range. It depends on the character. My gear in particular. Sorry, let me kill my Outlook here so I'm not getting email notifications, and therefore you're not hearing them and saying, oh, I got an email. Yeah. Actually, I was okay at Unreal. Back in, I think the last one I played was, what, Unreal 2004? I used to do LAN parties with my twin brother on that one. Excuse me. Yeah, UT 2K4. That's the one that I. Probably the last one I really invested significant time in, to be honest. After that point, DDO hit, and my gaming taste just sort of moved away from the first-person shooter genre. Yeah. Alright, so, let's see. We got Crystal Cove out. We had a hotfix on Monday to fix a crashing issue that you saw over the weekend. We have a patch out from last Thursday. You can find the release notes about that on DDO.com as well. And we are full bore in development of Update 27, which is War of the Archons. It's going to be a new adventure pack and a new raid, continuing the story of the Devil's Battlefield that you saw with, say, the Chavroth quests. And we're looking forward to bringing that to you on Lamania pretty darn soon. I mean, we are targeting later in July here for the update itself, ultimately when it's done, but we're targeting later in July here. So, should be seeing it on Lamania fairly soon, probably within a couple of weeks, I would think. Give or take a few days. Probably the latter half of a couple of weeks, but something like that. Yeah. My understanding, Erlock, is it is three quests in a raid. Not four quests in a raid. Three quests in a raid for Update 27 here. But again, yeah, that's what it is. So. I need to get some Omni spell. Sorry, I'm totally noobing it up, so I can cast haste upon myself. Yeah, I'm looking forward to letting you guys see the new raid in particular. I've been kind of peeking over the dev's shoulders here, and it's looking pretty hot, looking good. So I think you guys are gonna dig it. All right, it looks like we're ready to die slash succeed slash die. I really like this character that I made for the the fling. There we go. Jeez, where's my brain today? My brain is totally gone. What can I say? I'm sorry. Success is merely death warmed over. Success can be death. It depends on what your goal is. If your goal is to have fun, then it doesn't matter right?
Oh.
Yay, there's the first one. Not have a way to get past this. How do we do this? All right, we could see if I got a stone. I do. There we go. Woohoo! Here I can do good hope, and I can inspire competence. Two saves. Mr. Mass, why are there iconic past lives but no regular racial past lives? It's really was just a design choice that we didn't do. Oh, jeez. I'm gonna die again. I guess there's more, huh? There we go. Yep. Noop, noop, noop. Nooping it up on the live stream. I fought the trap and the trap won. Yeah, I'd say that's accurate. Yeah. Anyway, so update 27 is looking good. We should be able to get that to you up within, like I say, a couple of weeks here, most likely. And I'm really looking forward to doing that. I think you'll enjoy it. Killua44 asks, and by the way, thanks for joining us, Killua. I remember you being on a stream recently, mentioning that you're a pretty new player to DDO. It's great to have you here. What character do I play? Right now I'm playing a swashbuckler bard. What character do I usually play? Kind of depends. I have a whole bunch of different characters. But this is a swashbuckler bard. Pretty straightforward one that was made for the Spring Fling, which was a show that ended not that long ago. Well, I guess it was a little while ago now. Yeah, no new items for Crystal Cove. We are aware of your feedback that you'd like to see us do that, but we haven't yet done that. So it's still up to what 24, I believe, is where we are right now. So. It's an undead bard, Keith Richards. Kind of. That guy's certainly got some past lives. Yeah. Oh man, why did I do this quest? Well, you think we can pull a few of these guys up here first? Alright, so we basically just need to go past her. See if we can get them dancing. Maybe we should not have tried that. Yep. This is a tough quest, by the way. If you don't believe me, try it. Yeah. Pick up some Cerberus. I think we're gonna need it. There we go. No, I've died a lot. Come on, you know that. Alright, so yeah, we need to basically get away from Aurora, and we just need to sort of either have someone kite her around or just sort of deal with it. Generally, to have someone kite her around while we go through the rest of the quest. Get out of the way so I don't die. this quest. This is not gonna happen. Oh, happy Canada Day, right? Yeah, okay. So is Studio compatible with a custom UI? Yes and no. It does technically still support the old Lua, I believe, Lotro UI scripts that were brought into DDO quite a few years ago. But that said, it's not, you know, we did do a big UI interface since, or update since then, so it's kind of, yeah. Doesn't work for all elements. But it does work for some elements. I do know, I still see some people running with the, there was one in particular that was pretty popular. I can't think of the exact name of it right now, but it's the one that kind of has a blackish-gray looking UI. I do see that. Yep. Where is everybody? What are we up to? I'm guessing they're still fighting. What's her name? Do I have any more pots? I do. Get some healing potions in here as well. No, it's one that's a darker, almost dark transparent script. I wish I could remember the name of it right now. I actually was using it for quite a while. I think we should redo this on hard. This is just gonna take forever if we try to do this on elite. We're totally not ready for it. All right, I'm calling it. Let's just go back in on hard. This is just not going to happen on elite. Yeah, Blackbird. I think that's the name of it. Yeah, the Blackbird UI. That one was actually really cool. Like I said, I used that one for at home, actually, for quite a few years. It's one of those things that we've always had in the back of our mind that we'd like to, you know, re-update all that custom UI stuff, but it's going to be, frankly, a lot of work, and we just haven't really had the demand nor resources for it up till now. So, I mean, there is some demand. I don't want to say there's none. But enough to justify the cost and work as opposed to, say, doing other stuff. You know. Yeah, Blackbird UI. There you go. Jaren Aron asks, with update 27, will there be a new or expanded explorer area? The answer to that is no. We are not building a new wilderness area for update 27. We'll have the new quests and the new raid, but not a new wilderness area. Thanks, I could use it today. Why not just let the modding community do it? That's something I've looked into personally. I've asked, just said, hey, couldn't we just sort of, you know, put out all the UI elements? But the thing is, and those who have made custom scripts from back in the time will know that there was a lot of UI elements that had to be adjusted to work for DDO's UI. And I think that we just don't have the basically the available resources that the time it would take to get that to that state is also a lot of work. So, but it's something I can look into again if there's really enough demand for it. I just don't know that we're going to be able to fit it into our work schedule at this time. I think, you know, if we were to set aside time for UI work, it would probably be to make some adjustments, say, to the character sheet, that kind of thing, as opposed to, you know, getting a custom UI back up and running again. I'm Ezra Master if I've ever played the old SSI D&D games. Yeah, I did. It was a long time ago, though. I don't know. I don't really have a favorite. It's not really generally good to comment on other people's games. Even if they're old ones. But I liked them all. They were cool. Yeah, Pool of Radiance might be it, if I were to guess. That's a good one. All right, now that we know how bad it can be, let's try this again. So what we'll do is we'll try to have someone kite around the Merilith, and we'll work together to get through the hallways and open up the portals that we need to kill her. We actually have some really cool stuff that may get into update 27. I hope we can. I know I'm just being a tease here, but there's some things on that list that I think you guys will be extremely excited about should we be able to bring it to you. Hoping we can. Primarily, update 24 is going to be the new adventure pack, but we do have some kind of systems work that we're hoping to bring as well. And like I said, it's a little early because I don't want to make promises that, you know, some of this stuff is shall we say, ambitious. So whether it actually makes it into update 27 or perhaps an update or two after that remains to be seen. But okay. Well, anyone got a lot of MRR? Nicely done. Nicely done. Thank you. Ghostbane item. Or Ethereal Bracers or something. Yeah, Ghost of Chogman, that's what I should get. Remember, this guy was with the Spring Fling, so we were a get-as-you-go static group, so that's why I don't have that stuff. But now that the Spring Fling's no longer active, I could basically play him however I want. So perhaps it's time to do a little twinking. Yeah, to be honest, I haven't played this quest in quite some time myself, clearly. But, getting ready for the nice long weekend here. For those who don't know, we have a 4th of July in the U.S. here going on this weekend, so I don't know that we're going to have a Fridays at 4 this week. Kind of depends on sort of... You want to know the honest truth? Depends on whether or not my toddler takes a nap. If my toddler takes a nap around 4 o'clock, then yes, I will be live. If not, then I won't. So I'm going to kind of have to play it by ear. You seen any traps? cool. Someone's got the barrel. I like that one. It's going to be fun. You know, it's a good time if you do have a young one. Fireworks and that, they really appreciate them, especially in the Boston area. I don't know if you guys are familiar with the awesomeness of the Boston fireworks display, but it's up there. It's one of the bigger ones. It's pretty cool. Oh yeah, so we're going back through, right, and then doing the other path? Why'd you get off to Uranus? Oh, you're way at the front. She is. Did we miss something back here? Or am I wrong? Oh yeah, here's a lever. Oh, there's a lever. This quest will make you very afraid of levers. Yeah, I actually do know some people who, you know, especially back as it was a little bit closer to this pack or this adventure's release, they used to farm this actually for loot, because there are quite a few chests to be had if you get good at it. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, yeah, right. Karu says that was one of the better places for tome drops back in the day, at level range that it was. So that's right, right. It's an interesting conversation going on in chat, which is alignment important? I guess I would say in general, yes. I mean, there are some classes which have alignment restrictions. Some weapons, as the chat room is saying, that require certain alignments, like chaotic weapons or true law weapons. But in general, we do de-emphasize alignment somewhat in DDO. For one, we don't have an evil alignment. But the other aspect of it is that initially this game was released with the Eperon campaign setting. And for those of you who might be familiar with the Eperon campaign setting, Keith Baker specifically sort of downplayed straight ahead alignments in it. There's a little bit more kind of politics, and people can be both good and bad and what have you in the Eberron campaign setting. It's not that there is an alignment in Eberron either, because there is, but it's just takes a secondary. The goal was to take a bit of a backseat to storytelling and to be maybe a little more flexible in that regard than you see in some of the other campaign settings. I think probably alignment in DDO really does mostly play into the game in regard to a few character requirements for alignment, and then also in regard to multi-classing. There are certain multi-class combinations that just aren't really possible due to alignment restrictions, and alignment's something you're going to want to keep in mind as you're working through your multi-class building. And that's probably where you see it more often than any place else. Beating up the elderly. Elder Earth Elemental, but still. Later editions of the Eberron campaign setting allowed for even other sort of alignment-based gods. Like, you could have gods that would be whatever alignment you wanted. Oh, that's a good question. I mostly paid attention to the 3-5 setting for this campaign. So I guess someone else might know more than me, since I never really used gods a lot in my home settings. Oh, okay, that's an interesting question. Cranky the Eighth Dwarf asks, any plans to reuse or further use Ataraxia's Haven for future quest arcs? I don't know about Ataraxia's in particular, but I know in general with the question of are we going to use some areas that already exist for future quest arcs, I think the answer to that is yes. Some of it is practical, and some of it is given the amount of time that we have been able to develop public spaces, we have a lot of areas that have plenty of room for that kind of thing. So I do think in the future here we're going to see some further use of some of these areas that maybe have plenty of space for them. And that's kind of what we're seeing here with War of the Archons. You know, we're going to be bringing you Epic Vale of Twilight, later this year, and that that sort of continues that area as well. So I do think the answer to that is general yes. Alright, so I think we are ready to take care of the Merilith. Any idea where she might be?
Right behind you.
Oh, there you go. Make sure I got displace on. Alright, Voice of the Master's on, if you got it. Nice. Hey, in that time we only had one death. Not bad. Woohoo! You need some favor, Mesrum. Which server are you on, Mas? Are you on Kaneth, is that right? So I might, I've actually got someone on Caneth I'm looking to level up a bit. If we're on the same level, maybe we should get together sometime this week. Do I want that rapier? It's not terrible. Yeah, guess I'll take that. Oh, Thalanus. Oh, if you're looking for Thalanus in particular, and all you're looking for is favor, I've got quite a few characters that could help you out on that one. Mm-hmm. On Caneth, I'm actually pretty low level. I just started. I've been working on a character on Wayfinder, and I've got, I believe he's level 2, 3, 4, something like that, Druid on Caneth that I'm looking to level up. So... All right. Well, I don't know. I guess that gone for about an hour here. Maybe we'll call it. Unless you want to run something else quick. What else could we run quick? Try to get on normal. We could do Eye of the Titan, maybe. Do you guys have Inspired Quarter? Yeah, why don't we run one of these then while we can. I have one other character on Caneth too, but I kind of not really playing him much. I don't really like him that much, so I'm kind of letting him go. Why don't we do hard on this one as well? Well, if you enjoy completing monster manuals, ... Killua says, I can choose what level I want to be. That's not entirely true. When I'm playing on the live servers like this, I'm playing on the same kind of regular character that you would be playing on. I do have a little more flexibility in how many turbine points I have, but other than that... you know, I don't get special bonuses, I can't create loot for myself, I can't use an admin character to, say, give myself any sort of advantage, things like that. So it is a regular play character when I do play on the live servers. Sekihan would probably be the one I'd be using, Mesrim. So yeah, if you've got him on the friends list, that's the one I'd probably favor on with Jan. I do have a couple other characters on Thalanus, but Sekihan's the one I play more than anyone. That's the sort of the one I'm actually looking to sort of get stuff for. Oh man, I need Ghostbane. Coco, Warforged Titan. Yeah, are you talking about the thunder sound in particular for the... Is it the cone shape? That, if so, that's a bug, and that will be fixed in the near future. Probably the next update. Probably the next update. Red Piety asks a question. If I have a name, say, on Orion, can I have the same name on other servers? The answer is yes, unless someone else gets there first. All of our naming policy is first come, first served. So, depending on, say, the commonness of your name, then kind of depends. But one thing you can do, which I know some folks do, is they just make a quick character if they, like, really, really, really care about having a specific name for their character. They'll just kind of make a quick character on each one of the servers and grab the name, so to speak, so that no one else could take it. Maybe I shouldn't say that, but people have been doing that for as long as this game's been around. I myself may have Mock Duck on basically every server for that very reason. Oh, by the way, that crown thing is a known issue. Yeah, that's true, including some way back in beta that were not decided when they stopped playing or whatever to not delete their character names and open them up. You know, it does happen. There are a few names that you can't call yourself either, just because they're super popular names or copyrighted names in fiction, and we just have... Oh no, incoming. Good thing we have a Warforged Titan on our side. Yeah, that's not just a DDO thing, that's an MMO thing, right? Everyone, I know a bunch of people who are just like, well, I don't actually play the game, but I did go in and make sure that no one else can be the name that I like. Yeah, it happens. Please free up fairy for cosmetic pets. I had to name my great fairy Venus. Well, cosmetic pets, you don't have that same restriction. At least my understanding, right? I don't think we have a name restriction on cosmetic pets, so everyone could have the same name if they wanted to. You know, you could have a bunch of the same name. If you want to name your pet Tritz, I think you can. Oh, yeah, well, that specific name, someone mentioned a name in chat that has a different connotation that might be deemed offensive, and that's why that particular name is not allowed. We do have some names, you know, I mean, it's a normal name, and I'm sure your intention is not to use it in any kind of offensive manner, but it does happen. Right. I was glad someone looked that up. 3,000 favor needed for vet 7, status 7. Which is quite a bit, but certainly doable. Particularly if you're questing all the way up into the epic levels, you'll probably get pretty close to there. Provided you're running at least on hard, perhaps elite. Cylindrial, by any chance, can you do a remove... Oh, you got a remove curse? Okay. Never mind. Right. I'm healing. I'm hurting. I'm healing. I'm hurting. You know, I know that some, you know, we see on the forums every now and then, how's come all the good names are taken? I can't come up with a name. Really, I have to admit, I have not really had that problem. Maybe it's because I only choose bad names that nobody else would want, but, in my experience, given a little creativity, or perhaps even a kind of random fantasy name generator that you could find resources out there for, I haven't really found... it to be a big issue. So. Mesra Master, will I have to wait for the holidays, Christmas, to get more dance cookies? Probably. That's usually a festival thing, and that's usually in December. December or January. I would expect that to be the same this time. But as we just see on the live stream here, I've got a couple now called Kobold Killer. And got kind of shocked that was never taken. Every now and then, you get lucky on names. You're right, Peter 823 says, was Festival not sometimes biannual? That's right, we have had sort of a Festival in July event that we have done in years past. This year it's Crystal Cove in July, and that's really just due to the number of people who have said, can you please bring Crystal Cove back? So, you know. Yes, we can. The only one that goes into this quest goes dream her. Through the night. Don't sing on the live stream, Jerry. Jesus. Alright. Alright. You guys ready? Let's see if we can get ourselves something lucky here. Nope. All right, voices. Awesome. All right, that is going to do with the live stream here. Later on in the day here today, I will send you guys an in-game mail for it with a turbine point code. And thank you for torturing yourselves on Elite in the Demon's Den and then doing quite well on the other two. So, let's see. Right, Pidey says, if you read the info on the Ear Dweller, kind of gross. Cranky says, did the last patch take care of the crashes? Yes, it did. Monday's hotfix did fix the main crashing issue we were trying to address. I have seen a few people making posts that they may be still are having some kind of Osmium-related issues or whatever. We are looking into that, but yeah, the main thing that we hotfixed did get fixed. Yes. Any other questions? Let's see. Someone wants their Maybar back, darn it. Yeah, we are actually, we were just talking the other day. It's not going to be Maybar, you know, but we are doing another, I guess you would say, Halloween-themed event that we're planning to debut later this year. So you can look forward to that. It'll reuse some bits of Maybar, I think. I think we're going to keep some parts of it that you guys like, but it's going to be a new event as well. So, did Severlyn actually end up rolling up War? The Warforged War Chanter Warlock? No, I don't think so. But it was Varguil, actually, that was in the chat that said that one during the DDO Players News podcast. All right. So yeah, I think I just answered the Maybar question. Next Lemonia preview within a couple of weeks. Thank you very much for watching the weekly Wednesday lunchtime live stream. Don't forget to join us every Wednesday starting at noon Eastern, currently -4 GMT on twitch.tv/DDOstream. The videos are archived both on Twitch and on our YouTube page. That's youtube.com/DungeonsAndDragons, a one long word, no ampersand. And they usually go up later this afternoon, late Wednesday afternoons, is about when you can catch that stuff as well. Also, don't forget to find our entire schedule of shows here on Twitch, because we have shows basically every day, and you can do that again on twitch.tv/DDOstream. All right, thanks very much for joining us, and we will see you again soon.